Hey guys, it's Becky with Design Bundles, and I am here today to tell you about screen printing with your cutting machine. Now, we're going to be using our Silhouette Cameo, but all the concepts are the same, so even if you have a different cutting machine, this is not a video you want to miss, okay? It is super easy, and we're teaching you how to do it on the cheap. So all you need are a few supplies that you can usually find at your local craft store, and we have a great project for you. So let's go ahead and get started.
Okay, now when setting up my file, I tried to choose a file that, I don't want to say didn't have too many details. You can see this one has some little hearts and things like that, but files that if the details didn't come through too well, then it wasn't going to be a make or break. That, or you can pick a file that just is really simple and doesn't have any details at all. Okay, now I'm only saying that because we actually are going to do this on a smaller scale. This is for a kitchen towel, okay, a tea towel. And the size of my embroidery hoop that we're going to work with is an 8x8. It's an 8-inch circle. So what that means is I need to size this file to fit within that 8x8 circle. Okay, also keep in mind, really, the width for a tea towel, you're probably looking at around 6 inches. Now, it's okay that this one is a little bit bigger because we have these flourishes on the end of love, but just something to keep in mind. You don't want it to be too overwhelming on the tea towel itself. Okay, now what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to leave that circle on there, and I'm going to group these together. Now, let me say this, I'm showing you this on Silhouette Studio, but the concepts are the same if you're using Cricut Design Space. Okay, you're just gonna draw the circle, size down your material, or no, size down your file to fit within the circle, and then you can attach those together instead of grouping them. Now, if I go over to my send panel, I'm gonna update my material type to, I'm using glossy vinyl. My action is cut, and my tool is, I am going to use the ratchet blade. That's a personal thing for me. I prefer the ratchet blade. So if you're using the auto blade, then you can use the auto blade. Now I'm going to go ahead and do my test cut and cut this out of my adhesive vinyl. And then we will head on over there and I'll show you how to apply this and what materials we're going to use to get on with the screen printing.
Okay, so let's take a look at what we have here. This is our vinyl design. I have already weeded it. Our embroidery hoop, our tea towel, which is what our project will be on, some masking tape in case we need it. Now we have our screen printing ink, just a regular spoon to dip it out, and a squeegee, and that should be it. Okay, so let's get started. Oh, here's what I'm forgetting. The screen print mesh, okay. A lot of these supplies you can find right on Amazon or sometimes in your local craft store. So what first thing we're going to do is go ahead and loosen up this embroidery hoop brief. Okay, we will disassemble the two pieces. Now we want to lay this down. Now I did iron this out. Okay, so if your silk screen material is wrinkled, you can iron it out. Also, as a side note, some people use like a sheer organza fabric, so that's an option also. I'm going to take the inside hoop, slide it underneath, try to get this as centered as we can, and fit this around the outside. Okay, now we will go ahead and tighten this back up. It doesn't have to be super tight, but it definitely needs to be tight enough to hold your fabric. Okay, and then you want to work your way around the outside and pull your fabric tight. Now don't worry about the excess fabric, we can go back and trim that. Okay, now you just want to feel and make sure that your material is tight. And I am pretty happy with that. You can also pull from side to side. Alrighty, so I am going to trim around this. I don't need that much fabric getting in the way. Now they do make professional silk screen kits that you can buy instead of making your own. So this is just a really good way to try it out without investing a lot of money and material. All right, so let's grab some transfer tape for this. Well, this is the kind that I have. Nothing special about it. It has a paper backing and a red grid. But the grid actually isn't going to come into play And I just let the middle droop. Now I did cut this 8x8, so it matches up pretty well with the size of our circle. This is a high tack transfer tape, so there's little to no burnishing involved, which works out really well for me. Now we are going to apply this in the middle, but first I find it really, really useful to trim around the outside of our transfer tape, because otherwise it just gets in the way a little bit. Okay, now I did leave just a little piece up here. Okay, that'll help me when it's time to pull it off. And I want to center this in the middle if possible. Okay, now the reason that I put mine on the inside instead of on the back, like you may see some other tutorials do, is because it's so much easier to be able to press it to the material and to get a good burnishing. Okay, it can be a little difficult to apply vinyl to fabric like this. Okay, so it's already going to be enough of a struggle, and I just find that this makes it that much easier. Okay, so bear with me. Remember, I said that the adhesive vinyl doesn't like to stick to fabric. Okay, so we're going to find that little edge that I left. Okay, and we are going to pull back. Now, don't be surprised if you have to help this along with your fingers. All right, and remember, the edges don't matter. We're using this as a stencil. So what that means is that what we're most worried about is the center of the design. Okay, once you get it started, try to work it away from the edges a little bit. And then you can smooth the edges down with your fingers. Now, this is also why I talked about either choosing a simple design or at least a design that the details wouldn't make a big difference. So for example, I'm going to obviously fight to keep the inside of my letters, but I'm not going to fight for those individual hearts. They're really, really cute and I would have loved to have them, but you just have to pick your battles. So there we go. I feel like we're doing pretty good. As with any stencil, just give it one last glance over. All right, make sure that all of your edges are down. And then we are also, that's where the masking tape is going to come into play, because we are going to seal all the way around our outside edge. So what that means is we're just going to put some down, move it around. This is only for the simple benefit that no ink will leak between our vinyl and the outside of an embroidery hoop. Okay, make sure we don't end up with any little boo-boos around the outside of our design. All right, so I'm feeling extra good about that. Got all my edges taped off. Now, set this to the side. We want to lay out our tea towel. So locate where the tag is. There we go. So I always use the middle of the end with no tag. You want to get it as flat as possible. So we will go ahead and iron this out. Now we want to position our design. I like to go a little bit up from the bottom, so that will be what, probably about 4 inches. Position it as straight as I can. Now we are going to grab our screen printing ink. I have a sealed bottle, so I can give it a little shake. Now, we don't need a lot, so definitely give it a stir and then spoon some out. Be very careful with this part. You don't want to get it on your material, and you want to apply it where there is no exposed design, okay? Now, I always like to tell everybody that more is more, Screen printing is not a craft where you need to so much worry about too much ink, because you can scrape it back off and put it back into the container, okay? Put a healthy amount on there. And I also think that screen printing is like a buddy craft, because if you happen to have a second pair of hands available, then that is really useful too. So what we're gonna do, this is our squeegee. We're going to squeegee the ink straight into our design. Now, professional screen printers, they have one big squeegee, right? And they're able to squeegee it in one pass, which is really great. We're going to give ours just a couple passes since we are not professionals. And we want to end with our ink back over to one side. Okay, so set your squeegee down, and we are going to peel from one side to the other. I'm holding it very tightly with this hand over here, and I just want to lift off. And there we go. There is my cute and really awesome little design. Now, the good news is that I can take this, reposition it back onto another surface, and screen print again and again, as long as my stencil holds up in really good shape. So, what did you think about our project? Now, I personally love the gold, especially on this beautiful white towel. And this is something that I will definitely be proud to hang in my kitchen. Now, one thing I forgot to tell you about in the tutorial is after your ink dries, you do want to heat seal it onto your fabric. Okay, so I usually press about 320 for 30 seconds, maybe a little bit longer. And that just really gives it that finishing touch, and it makes sure that it's not gonna wash out when you put it in the washing machine. So, all right guys, I really appreciate you joining me today. If you have any questions or comments about anything that we've done or anything that you wanna see, make sure you leave them in the comment section below, because I do come back and personally check in with you, right? And of course, make sure you subscribe to the channel, because we have a lot more fun planned for you right around the corner. Thanks, guys. We'll see you next time.